The team behind Missing Richard Simmons is back with an update and a whole new story. The series is called Headlong, Surviving Y2K. Remember Y2K? The Armageddon that never happened? From an evangelical family preparing for the apocalypse to the coders who fixed the millennium bug, follow their stories through New Year's Eve 1999 and find out what happened at midnight. Plus, host Dan Taberski shares his own Y2K story. It's called Surviving Y2K because Dan barely did. Listen to the entire series ad-free now on Stitcher Premium.
Welcome. Welcome, friends. Don't you know that this is a good time for us all to be together? Me doing a podcast, you listening to one. Those are the choices. Do a podcast or listen to a podcast. Eventually, we all must choose. Okay. I have this idea for like a purge type scenario. Where one night a year, everyone chooses whether they listen to podcasts or do podcasts. Now, that seems like a very simplistic idea. First of all, Mona Lisa, most famous painting of all time, just a lady. So don't knock simple ideas. Number two, it's going to be trickier than you think because a lot of people do podcasts and listen to them. Very few people, a lot of people just listen. Very few people do them and don't listen to other ones. Can you imagine that? The self-absorption that you're going to say, I'm going to do a podcast. I'm never going to listen to any of them. Okay. Who are you, Prince? Only listens to his own music. It's one of my favorite urban legends. I don't know that that's true, but I once heard that Prince only listened to his own music. That, like, how would that, how would you find that out? Like, if you went over to Paisley Park and Prince said, I put on some music. And he puts on his own music. And, like, his best friend, I don't know who Prince's best friends were, Dr. Phil, would be like, are you listening to your own music? Can I tell you something? The other day, I saw a promo for Dr. Phil. That show's still on. That, like, look, Judge Judy, I get why that's still on. If it ain't broke, don't fix it. But I feel like Dr. Phil, even more than Jerry Springer, whatever. Is that still on? No? I'm being told no. Do people know for sure? Some people don't know for sure.
For sure.
Some people seem... How dare you? You know how we do things here. Anyway, look, Dr. Phil, if you have a podcast, you better stop it. You got that show. Are you still sending kids to boot camp? What are you doing? Like, Judge Judy, I get it. People still have, they have bad neighbors. They have people in their lives who are garbage. And they have to go with their receipts and get yelled at by Judge Judy. That makes sense to me. Dr. Phil, are you trying to send all of our nation's teens and tweens to boot camp? You fascist? Dr. Phil is trying to institute a military state in this country. Got news for you, Dr. Phil. It's already here. Okay, I've said too much. This is supposed to be a fun show. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Spontaneanation with Paul F. Tompkins. I am the second part. This is a show where I invite a special guest onto the program to join me. Nope. Yes. I moved something on the table and it derailed my entire train of thought from this thing that I've said 100 plus times. This is a show where I invite a special guest onto the program to join me in a free-form conversation inspired by a blind question from our previous episode's guest. Then I invite some improviser pals to join me in a narrative improv that is one continuous story as opposed to unconnected scenes? Inspired by a location provided by the aforementioned special guest and oftentimes utilizing details gleaned from that freeform conversation. And it is all scored on piano by Mr. Eban Schletter. That's what he goes like. Folks, I'm very excited to have this person here in our studio today. And we are recording in the new Earwolf Studios. That's right. They moved down a couple floors, and we're here for the first time. The microphone goes one way, and you better be the way that that microphone is. I tried to twist this microphone to where my face was, and the microphone is fighting me like a ghost. I knew I shouldn't even have mentioned the new studio, because I've cursed us. I'm very excited to have this person here. You will recognize her from the television program Crazy Ex-Girlfriend and also the movie The Big Sick, among many other things. Please welcome to SPONTANEANATION, Vella Lovell.
Thank you.
Vella, did I pronounce your last name correctly?
You did, okay. Yeah.
I realized I didn't ask you. It seemed logical to me.
You did it. You scored a 10 out of 10.
10 out of 10 already. Well, I have a question for you. First of all, let me say, welcome to the new studio.
Thank you so much. It's already haunted. I love it.
I have a question for you. This is from our previous episode's guest. And that question is, which celebrity would you like to die in the arms of?
Oh, my gosh. That's a really loaded question.
It is. I mean, you gotta pick wisely.
Yeah.
You don't want to get it wrong.
Because it's like, that's going to be the face that's ushering you out.
Yeah.
So like.
Last thing you're going
to
see?
I feel like I should just say that the celebrity that came to mind, which was Maggie Smith. I don't know why her wrinkled face just appeared in my mind. It's like, maybe that would be nice to die too.
Can I tell you? 10 out of 10.
Really?
Absolutely. I did not have a person loaded up. That would be a perfect person.
Yeah.
To usher you out of this world.
I was thinking of her in Hook. That was her in Hook, right?
Yeah, she played the older Wendy.
Yeah, yeah, just thought of her in like that chair, just being like, you may go. And I was like, yeah.
Now, Vella, I'm a little older than you.
Well.
You don't want to say anything? But Hook, I saw Hook as an adult.
Oh, okay.
So for me, it is not a touchstone.
Really?
And it also is not a good movie.
Oh my God, that just like hurt me that, to the core. I was like, you know Hook, right? We all grew up with Hook.
This is the thing.
Oh gosh.
People younger than me love this movie. And I almost walked out of it when it came out.
Oh my gosh. So are people saying like, there you are, Peter. And you're like, what are you talking about? Exactly. Who's Peter?
It's a lot of Bangarang and it's a lot of Rufio.
Rufio. Those were the main things.
Yeah.
Those were the main things.
Absolutely.
Although I had such a specific experience the other day. I was like at some kind of like reception thing and there was like a cheese platter. Mm-hmm. And I was like, this reminds me of the feast from Hook. And the person who I was with was like, what are you talking about? But another person was like, I know exactly what you're talking about. Cause it was like, it all had a gleam to it.
Yeah.
It was a very shiny, specific feast that the Lost Boys had.
And they get in a food fight, right?
And it's kind of more like paint.
Yes, that's right.
Like as a kid, I was always like, I can't wait to eat paint. Like, it looks delicious. It was like a pie of paint that they were eating now that I think about it.
Did you? And I love that Julia Roberts as Tinkerbell is just like over to the side like, I won't be in the food fight.
Yeah, yeah. But she's enjoying it.
Yeah.
Like she's in her little cage.
Having a great time watching
She's having a great time. Yeah. Yeah. Oh my God. And Dustin Hoffman was
Captain Hook.
That's right. And that other dude was, someone was Smee, who was fun.
Bob Hoskins, I believe.
Right.
Yeah. I know a lot, for a movie I saw once and didn't
like,
I know a lot about it.
I'm just like, and you know all the facts about it. Yeah, that was a good one. That was it. Maybe I can't watch it as an adult because maybe it's bad. That's so scary.
No, I don't. I think what happens now is, and this is like, I wish that this could be grandfathered in for my generation, but it seems like anything you liked as a kid gets a pass forever.
Yeah.
That seems to be what is happening. There are things that I liked as a kid that I was crushed to find out that I did not like as an adult.
Yeah. It's heartbreaking because you think you have really good taste, I guess, when you're like 8. You're like, I knew it. I knew quality art. Okay.
Do you remember the first time? Because I remember the first time I saw a movie.
Uh-huh.
And I was bored by it.
Oh.
And it was a thing that was supposed to be for me. And I remember thinking like, why? It was a weird process. Like, why am I not liking this? It's a movie.
Right. I'm supposed to be entertained. Yeah. And you were just like, next. How old were you?
Oh, I must have been like preteen, I think.
You were like 12 and you were over it.
Yeah.
I wonder what the movie was.
And I felt guilty. I think it was Tron. I think it was the movie Tron.
Don't know that one.
It's not good.
Okay.
But again, has a weird cult around it.
Right.
Has a weird cult around it. One of our friend of the show, Little Janet Varney, is a huge Tron fan.
Okay.
But I think it's very much because it's an emotional attachment that she has because her father used to... Like they saw the movie and then he used to play this game with her where he would pick her up and race her around the room.
Oh,
like
that's fun. Yes. It was like a good memory.
Well, then of course you have to love that movie forever.
Right. You're like, someone picked me up and whirled me around the room. It was a great time. Yeah.
Who were your celebrities when you were a kid?
When I was a celebrity?
Yeah. Well, like who were your Maggie Smiths when you were a kid?
I'm trying to think because my mom would only let me watch PBS when I was a kid.
One of those?
So I don't really, I'm one of those. Yeah. Like I literally saw that LeVar Burton poster out there and I was literally like, oh, I guess it was LeVar Burton. I was literally like, oh my God. I didn't know he had a podcast and I was like, I gotta listen.
From Reading Rainbow?
Yeah, Reading Rainbow.
Right. His podcast is he reads to you.
Stop.
That's literally
what?
It. Yes.
Like LeVar, he reads you to sleep. Yeah. He's just like, go this oh my God. Yeah. He was my guy every Sunday. I'd be like, let's go, LeVar. And then actually, my first experience of realizing that actors were actors was I saw an episode of Star Trek, and I was like, wait, what's LeVar Burton doing in space? Like, I was like, this doesn't, what do you mean? Like, because, I didn't realize actors were like...
Because on PBS, you don't see those people do anything else. Like Maria from Sesame Street is not popping up on Law and Order.
No.
Although that said, she might.
She probably did, but I didn't know about Law and Order, so I was like, there's Carmen Sandiego, there's Rockapella, there's Sesame Street, and there's LeVar Burton.
Right.
Those were my celebrities, I guess. So when I saw him on Star Trek, I was like super confused. I was like, what?
Would you be sort of sneaking TV at friends' houses and stuff like that?
It's funny you mentioned that. Yeah, because Jerry Springer. I would get home from, my mom wouldn't get home till like 5. So I would have like 2 hours of like sneakily watching television and I would watch like the trashiest TV.
Oh.
So I was watching Jerry Springer, Jesse Raphael.
How old are you at this time?
Went on for a while. It was probably like 9 to 13. Yeah. And then I would watch some soap operas too.
Yes.
Yeah. It was Young and the Restless.
Yeah.
Like watch some Sally Jesse Raphael, some Maury, and then my mom would come home and I'd be like, I was practicing piano the whole time and doing my homework. But
the whole time.
I think that's what happens though when parents try to like really like go really far in one direction, you just end up like freaking out.
It's almost like no TV would have been better than some TV.
Because you get a little taste.
Yeah. And you know it's out there. I don't know. We watched a ton of TV when I was a kid. It was not.
Yeah.
That was never an issue.
And now, how do you feel about TV? Are you like, I could take it or leave it? Or are you like,
I like TV.
You like it?
Yeah,
okay.
I do.
But
I
probably
do.
In a healthy way.
When my wife and I moved into our house, we had a, the house has a fireplace. And we had a very brief discussion about, do we put the TV over the fireplace?
Oh my gosh, yeah, that's a real question.
Yeah, and then we said, yeah, why, we're not going to pretend that we don't watch TV. We do watch TV.
Right.
And if we have people over, sometimes we will watch stuff with them. We don't have to turn the TV on if we have people over.
Right.
But if we do, it makes sense that that's where it is. We have to live here every day.
Every day.
Yeah.
We have to deal with these consequences.
Yeah.
Well, did you do you feel like you had like the conundrum because it, over the fireplace feels important?
Yeah, exactly.
Because that's what I had when I moved into my apartment a year ago. Is it's not a working fireplace, which I'm also confused by. I'm like, so what is this for? But I was like, where do I put the TV? Because am I saying that like TV is so important to me? And I was like, then people will come over and they'll know. I don't know. It's like it took up a lot of
space. What did you do?
I didn't put it over the
TV.
Wow. But now it's awkwardly on the side wall and I'm facing the fireplace and I turn my head.
Yeah.
Yeah. And now I have neck problems.
Oh, no.
No, that's a lie. But like, but I do think about it sometimes. I'm like, it would have been easier.
Yeah. But because I think most people that you know, they watch TV too. Why are we pretending?
Why are we trying to hide from our true selves that just want to watch trash TV?
Yeah. Let's say you want to watch a movie. Let's say you want to put on the Yule log at Christmas time.
And pretend like you have a fireplace over your real fireplace.
You have a gigantic fireplace over your dead fireplace that doesn't do anything.
And then you feel like you did it.
That's right. Yeah. You feel like you did it.
You won life. You have two fireplaces.
So when you were a kid watching TV, what did you ever get caught watching stuff that you were not supposed to watch?
Oh my, you're asking all the questions.
I'm asking all of
them. I've wanted to talk about this for years. I remember one time, because I would always be like, oh, I could hear my mom's car. And then I'd be like, turn it off, have plenty, like go get a snack. I'd be like, hey, mom, you know, wasn't doing that. But like,
just taking a break from piano to have a baby bell.
Oh my gosh. That's baby, let me take the wax off the cheese.
Oh, hello. I didn't see you there.
Yeah.
I've been doing this for hours. Why do they make these so hard?
But like, it's probably that thing of like, I was 9. I'm sure she knew. I'm sure she knew because I was probably like, hey, what's up? But I remember a couple times, like I was either really involved in The Young and the Restless or something and I didn't hear her and I would do the fast like turn off the television thing and then just be like, I was just looking at the wall. Like I would pretend, I'd still try and pretend, you know? And I think she knew. I think she had to know. Because it was just so, like, you're 9. You can't cover up things, you know?
I trip out on that a lot. The amount of stuff as a parent that you just have to let go. Like, when you know your kid is absolutely lying to you. And you're like, this isn't worth it.
Totally. Yeah, or I always think about with parents, like, when your kid, because I know I did this, like, you get really mad, but you're 5. And you're just like, you don't know me. And I'm like, how hilarious must that be as a parent when you're just like, this little being is just yelling at you, like letting you have it. And you're just like, you are fine. But you have to like take them seriously.
Yeah.
Because you don't want to like crush their spirit so soon. But like, kids are just insane in that way.
I had a friend who had a little boy. This was years ago. Her little boy who's now like a man. Mm-hmm. He was being ornery. She's trying to like feed him and he doesn't want to eat anything.
Yeah.
And she said, how about I make you some SpaghettiOs? Mm-hmm. And he said, I don't want any fucking SpaghettiOs. And he's like 6 years old.
My God.
And I said, what did you do? And she said, well, I had to turn away because I was laughing.
Laughing so hard. Cause you're like, what?
She's like this little, I don't want any fucking SpaghettiOs.
Cause she's probably like, that's perfect.
Yeah.
Yeah.
When kids know how to curse, when they accidentally get it right, that's the best thing in the world.
You're like, that is a sentence that is correct. How you use that.
Somebody here has a niece. We're going to get into that later. That is one of the greatest videos I've ever been sent in my life.
Oh my God. Just a kid who knows how to curse. I'm like, that's amazing.
Vella Lovell, thank you so much for being here.
Thank you for having me.
It was
me.
A this delight to have you.
It was a dream.
Absolutely. And so it's Monday, November 19th, as people are hearing this. Mm-hmm. What would you like to promote? What do you want people to know about? Where can people find you online?
Well, okay, you can find me online at my Instagram is Vella Marie, because that's my middle name. really original.
And if you needed an explanation.
If you needed to know. And then my Twitter is just Vella Lovell, just my first and last
name. There you go. And yeah. anything coming up that you
actually
can talk about?
So I'm voicing a mermaid in the new She-Ra reboot that's coming out on Netflix.
Wow.
Which is kind of a dream come true. It's the dream I didn't know I had.
Right.
And it'll come out the 16th, so you could watch it if it was the 19th. Even if you're an adult, you can still watch cartoons.
They can't stop you from doing it.
No one can stop you
yeah.
from living your dream. That's what I'd like to promote.
Vella Lovell, thank you again.
Thank you for having me.
Folks, we're going to take a break. During the break, we will procure a location for our improv from our guest Vella Lovell. And then when we return, we will meet our improvisers. Stay alive. No matter what occurs, I will find you.
Uh-oh, I got a question for you, and it's very personal. Do you wake up feeling achy, easily distracted, or forgetting things? Ugh, what a horrible way to wake up is to forget something. It's bad to feel achy when you wake up. It's bad to feel easily distracted, like you want to get out of bed, but you get distracted by, you know, a bird outside your window. But to wake up forgetting things, ugh. That's not good. A quality night's sleep makes all the difference, and the right mattress is the key to getting proper rest instead of just laying down. There's a big difference, guys. The Lisa mattress is the product of 30 years of experience and hundreds of hours of rigorous product testing. Were robots involved? I wouldn't be surprised. Did they count electric sheep? That's androids. Designed for body contouring and pressure relief, the Lisa mattress is perfect for all sleepers. Shop conveniently online with free shipping and 100 nights to try the mattress in your own home. The Lisa mattress is backed by more than 12,000 five-star reviews. That's a lot. And loved by more than 300,000 happy sleepers. I love you, happy sleepers. Lisa also donates one mattress for every 10 sold, so you can sleep easy and feel good about your purchase. Right now, get $150 off the Lisa mattress plus a free pillow. Yeah, that's part of sleeping. At leesa.com/PFT and enter promo code PFT at checkout. This is Lisa's best offer at leesa.com/PFT. Promo code PFT. That's leesa.com/PFT. Promo code PFT. Robin Hood, the hero. Robin Hood, the app? Yes, it has come to pass. Modern times. Robin Hood is an investing app that lets you buy and sell stocks, ETFs, options, and cryptos, all commission free. I know what all of that means. So, even if you are a stock market newcomer, you can invest for the first time with true confidence. Honestly, the best kind of confidence there is. Look it up. While other brokerages charge up to $10 for every trade, Robinhood doesn't charge commission fees, which means you can trade stocks and keep all of your profits. Do you get the Robinhood connection now? And with a clear design and easy to understand charts and market data, Robinhood lets you place a trade on your smartphone in just 4 taps. That's 3 taps. Or it didn't get the job done. Or if you are on the web, which let's face it, all of us are, you can view stock collections like the 100 most popular, as well as sectors like entertainment and social media and more curated categories like female CEOs. Plus, you can discover new stocks and track favorite companies with a personalized news feed. And get custom notifications for price movements so you never miss the right moment to invest. How many times have I done it? I don't even want to tell you because it's embarrassing. Robinhood is giving listeners a free stock like Apple, Ford, or Sprint to help build your portfolio. So sign up at spont.robinhood.com. That's spont.robinhood.com. You get ready to rob from the rich and pay the poor. That's you. Assuming.
Welcome back, folks. It is time to meet our friends from the world of make pretend. Sitting right next to me. This performer has gotten so many compliments on her pants today. Kimia Behpoornia is back. No, Kimia Behpoornia.
There you go.
I can't believe that was the very first time I messed it up.
That's the first time. But it's okay because I liked it because you came in confidently. You did it again and I'm proud.
It was just nostalgic, I guess.
I guess
so.
From
when we first met.
I guess so. I'm okay with it.
Kimia, how are you doing?
Me, I'm great. Let's see. I've been doing crossword puzzles. Is that exciting to admit? No? I head shaking, I see.
Did you feel that it was tough for you to admit that?
Nope. I was excited to admit it. I was very excited to say. Because I thought, you know, I thought I didn't know. I've never completed them before. And recently I've been completing some.
It's something that you used to do and then, or would you just do it occasionally?
No, it's something I'd never put that much effort into, but because I thought it was too hard. And if I ever attempted it, I'd only get two answers. But now I can finish puzzles. So,
what, do you do books? Do you just do them in the paper?
No, I got the. See, I really think this is a phase for me. So I bought the New York Times subscription just for monthly. Yeah. Edgar's ashamed.
Wait,
I don't know why.
You get the New York Times once a month?
Yeah, once a month. Because I really. You could pay for the whole year monthly. And I was like, this is certainly a phase of my life. So I just pay monthly until I cancel it when I'm over across.
Oh, I'm sorry. So you don't get one paper a month?
Oh, no. I have the app.
You can end the subscription.
Yes.
I see. On a month-to-month basis.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
I get it now. Okay.
Yeah.
And the Times puzzle is supposed to be the hardest. The one on, is it the Sunday Times is the hardest one?
I think Saturday is the hardest one. Sunday is apparently a different kind of puzzle or something. But I can only complete Mondays, the easiest puzzle.
That's what you say for now.
Yes, for now. I'm training.
But then... mm-hmm. For a big puzzle contest.
That's right.
I can't find this. I'm so mad. I'm sorry. I can't find this video.
It's okay. It's not like the thing I was saying was interesting enough to keep many people's attention anyway. I should have gone in with something more hype. But I went with crossword puzzles.
Something more hype.
Really. Let's see. I saw that Beyonce Jay-Z concert. Is that cooler?
That is kind of cool.
Well, it's
you were there in person?
I was there, yeah. I was there. You know, I don't have a story about that. I could have talked about crosswords way more than that concert.
Did they see you there?
No. Of course not.
Have you ever made eye contact with a performer on stage, like a singer?
No, not a singer. But at UCLA, we had this giant talent show every year called Spring Sing. And there's a group that hosts Spring Sing. And all we do is, like, UCLA-related sketches between everybody's performance. And I was part of Company, which is what that group is called. And we would have celebrity judges. They wouldn't judge anything. They were just there.
Sure.
And
I would hope they wouldn't judge anything.
Yeah, right? But there are winners and stuff. People get awards.
Sure, yeah.
Dennis Quaid was there once, and when he walked out, I like did a woo woo, and I think he pointed right at me. That's about it. Yeah.
I may have told this story on this show before, I'm not sure, but I went to see the singer Jonathan Richman do a show in Hollywood at a relatively small venue here in Hollywood, and I was told. That he makes intense eye contact with the audience. And I was like, I don't even understand that. And then I went and it happened and it was very uncomfortable.
Oh my goodness.
Because here's the thing. Like if somebody's on a stage and their eyes, if you're seeing a play or something and their eyes light on you for a moment, that's like already like, oh, that was crazy. Like this person, we had a weird 1 second connection. This Jonathan Richman fellow, he looks at you for like, this long, as long as I'm looking at you right now.
Yeah, but
still. Now that's too long.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
We're not having a conversation. He's singing a song.
But he's just looking right at
me. He's just looking right at me.
Okay.
And then he moves away. But it's unsettling.
Yeah.
Now I'm sure for other people, if you're like a super fan of this person, you'd be losing your mind, like, oh my God, he looked at me for like a half a minute.
Sure.
But I like his music fine. Mm-hmm. I didn't want to have an emotional connection with him.
Yeah. It sounds uncomfortable. I also, it was. Isn't it hard to see people with the lights and stuff anyway?
You would think, but yeah. He seemed to know that he was looking at everyone.
He sounds crazy. I don't.
He sounds crazy.
I don't like it.
Kimia.
Yeah.
On that note, I'm going to look away from you.
Okay.
To look directly across the table from you, kitty corner from me, meow.
Don't do it.
Yeah.
Thank you. Don't do it. Edgar Momplaisir is back.
Ooh, oingo boingo.
Oingo boingo, you said a mouthful. Edgar, were you allowed to watch TV when you were a kid?
I was in a similar situation as our guest, but like, you know, my mom wasn't home a lot. She worked doubles. Mm-hmm. So, you know, I watched what I wanted to watch until one summer. There was a Hurricane Isabel in New York, and we used to have two satellites. We had the regular dish, mm-hmm. and then we had a dish that was like the Hope Network dish, which was only Christian channels. And then Hurricane Isabel knocked out the regular dish and left that one up, and my mom was like, this is a sign from God.
Oh, no.
So she only let that be up for a bit, and then I got into movies. I would watch her old VHS tapes.
What were her movies?
I watched On the Town, Singing in the Rain.
I think I heard you talk about this on Culture Kid.
Yeah, and then I watched the original, or not, maybe not the original Star is Born, maybe the second A Star is Born. And that was like...
what's her name? With Judy Garland, that
yeah,
one?
Yeah, and my God, that movie's fucking dark.
Yeah.
It's a dark story. I watched it when I was like 11 or 12. And I was like, what the fuck?
What did your mom do that she was working doubles?
She was a nurse. Both of my parents are nurses.
Right. That's right. That's right. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Did they meet as nurses?
You know, that's a good... No, my dad was a cab driver when he met my mom. Do you want to know how he met my mom?
I do.
I think Kimmy has heard this story. She really likes it. For Thumbs some reason. Up. My dad would give my mom's sister a ride from home after church, and then in Haitian culture, you can't just drop someone off at the front of the house. You have to walk them up upstairs and say hello to everyone in the family. Like you can't. So he went upstairs and then he was like, "Hey, yo, who's this woman?" Like right. We saw my mom, so he kept giving my mom's sister a ride home.
Oh, I'm sorry. You have to do it every single time?
Oh, yeah. You can't just drop someone off.
After you've met the whole family, you still have to do it.
You have to say hello.
It's me again.
Like, yeah. So he would do that, and then he was just like, you know, spitting game every time he went over.
But now your dad's not Haitian, right?
He is.
He is Haitian.
Oh, I'm double.
So he... So he knew the score. He knew to do this. Yeah. And it worked out good.
Yeah, he was a cabbie back then in New York. Yellow cabbie.
So then so your mom was a nurse at that point? Or she was in nursing school?
She was in school, yeah. She was in school and then she made my dad become a nurse.
She made him.
Look, you wanna think that I'm being funny, but I'm not. She made him. My mom has made my dad do a lot of things. Like move to the border of Mexico.
Oh. What? Okay, so was he perfectly content being a cab driver?
I don't think he was content. He got shot one time, so I don't know if he was content.
That will take the contentment right out of you.
Yeah, I don't think he was happy about it.
How many times was he shot at a nurse?
You know, not enough. Not enough to make him stop doing it.
Is your mom still working to this day?
Yeah, she just recently became a nurse practitioner.
Wow.
Which is like, you know, she can write prescriptions.
Yeah.
And she's real excited about that. She calls me. I don't know if I should say this on the air, but she'll touch me and be like, hey, what do you need? And I'm like, Mom, you can't
what?
Do this.
What do you need?
Maybe I shouldn't say that on the air.
We can cut that out.
No, don't cut it out.
Are you
sure?
She
should learn from her mistakes.
I'll check back with you when this is about to release.
She'll never listen. But maybe she'll never.
Yeah, it's not so much about her listening.
Listen, HIPAA, come for my mom. She's ready.
First, do no harm. Edgar, I'm going to look away from you.
Of course, of course.
To look next to you, directly across from me. I can barely see her. We got a big night lamp situation happening here.
There we go.
Carla Cackowski is back.
Paul, I'm so sorry I talked in your opening. It was crazy.
I'm glad you remembered.
That was the craziest thing that's ever happened to me. I listen to this podcast all the time, and anytime anybody does that, I
usually I'm listening with Craig in the car. I turn to him. I'm like, this person, do they never listen to this podcast? What is happening?
It's very rare.
I'm so sorry.
This is only like, I think, the third or fourth time that it's happened.
Oh, God.
And yours was so small. But here's the thing. I was also asking a question.
You were
I needed
looking
confirmation
at me.
For something. I was looking at you. What you did, your instinct made sense. Okay. I do not fault you for it. It is water under the bridge, dear friend.
Thanks, Paul.
Now, let's get down to children cursing. Carla, tell us about your niece.
I have a really cute niece.
Mm-hmm. She's extremely precious.
She's very precious. And it's one of those things where I don't have children and I don't like to talk about other people's children. I generally don't care. but I'll be like polite. Or whatever, and be like, yeah, you have a cute kid. But, and then my brother had a baby.
Like bullet teeth. Yeah, I guess it's cute.
Yeah, I guess. Sure. Then my brother had a baby, and like all of my maternal instincts, all of a sudden I was like, I need to have a baby.
Right.
I love babies. Still not having babies. But anyways, she's adorable. And
her name is Penny.
Her name is Penny.
Which, by the way, I've said this before, and I'll say it again. Until it ceases to be true, but I don't think it will. I have never met someone with the name Penny that was not a fantastic person.
Oh, really?
I've liked every Penny I've ever met. It's true.
Good. That's good to
know. I think it's a good name.
So, yeah. So if you're out there and you're pregnant and you're listening to Spontaneanation,
you can do a lot worse than Penny.
anyway, so she's just great. She's funny and she's... I post videos of her that my siblings sent me of her like talking to herself in the mirror.
Yeah.
And so about a year ago, my brother sent me a video of her. He caught her saying fuck for the first time. And for some reason, I just had to send it to Paul.
It's
and Janie.
Oh, it's a two-part video because you sent us the first part after the second part. And so the first video we see is... Penny says she's sitting in the bath and she's playing with some toys.
Yeah.
And it looks like she's cleaning the toys.
I think she's cleaning
like she's
the
giving
toys.
The toys a bath.
Yeah, exactly.
And then she says, fuck it. And then you hear off camera dad say, what did you say? And then she goes, fuck it. And then she laughs her head off. And she, you have to picture this little red-haired, she's adorable, and she says it like, I've said it that way many times in my life. But then she said it, you sent us the prequel video,
yeah,
which is Penny is cleaning a toy, she's bathing a toy, and then she just says kind of almost under her breath, she goes, fuck it. And then she whips around and looks at the camera like,
did you
hear what I said?
Oh, it's pretty great.
Do you have the video on your phone?
I sent them to you. I just sent them. Did you get them?
Let's get that. Let's get this video. I'm so excited.
Did it come through?
They did come through. Okay. All right. Here we go. That's the initial fuck it.
What did you just say?
Fuck it.
Oh, Penny, I love you as I love all pennies around the world. Ladies and gentlemen, we have to take a break. When we return, we will reveal the location for our improv suggested to us by our guest Vella Lovell, and then we're going to do that improv. All this and nothing else when Spontaneanation returns.
A stitch in fix saves time. That's right. The old expression has been updated. Stitch Fix is an online personal styling service that finds and delivers clothes, shoes, accessories to fit your body, budget, and lifestyle. Now, do you understand the updating of the old expression? It saves you time. Stitch Fix can help you find your new favorite piece or pieces of clothing. Just go to stitchfix.com/PFT. You tell them your sizes, what styles you like, how much you want to spend on each item. It's just that simple. You then get paired with your very own personal stylist who will hand pick using their hands 5 items to send right to your door. You use your hands to open the door. Hands are important. Then you try them on. You pay only for what you love. And you return the rest. Shipping, exchanges, returns, they're always free. This sounds like a good deal. There's no subscription required. You can sign up to receive scheduled shipments or get your fix whenever you want. Stitch Fix's styling fee is only $20, which is applied toward anything you keep from your shipment. This is the $20 you were going to spend on transportation, parking, popsicles. A lot of times when you're on your way to buy clothes, you buy popsicles you don't need. This eliminates that. Get started now at stitchfix.com/PFT, and you'll get an extra 25% off when you keep all 5 items in your box. And the reward is yours. That is stitchfix.com/PFT to get started today. Stitchfix.com/PFT.
Welcome back. Oh boy. My friends, the time has arrived. The time has arrived. It is time to reveal the location for our improv provided to us by our guest Vella Lovell. But first, just so you know, in order to aid us in our storytelling. I just developed a speech impediment. In order to aid us in our storytelling, we use 3 sound effects that move us about in space and time. Let's say we're in a scene and we need to travel into the past for some reason. Someone's having a memory. We're learning how something came to be. Anytime we travel into the past, we use this flashback sound effect. But you can't stay in the past forever, folks. Anytime we want to get back in time, return from the flashback back to where we were, or anytime we're moving forward in time, we use this flash forward sound effect. Now, this last sound moves us only in space, not in time. Let's say we're in a scene. We need to find out what is happening at the exact same moment somewhere else. Anytime we move sideways in time, we use this meanwhile sound effect. Past. Present. Future. Everyone gets it. And now, ladies and gentlemen, it's time to reveal the location for improv. Grandma's kitchen. Grandma's kitchen. We take you now to Grandma's kitchen.
Sweetheart, what were you watching? Were you watching what I think you were watching in the other room just now?
LeVar Burton?
Yes, you know how I feel about LeVar. I love him.
Oh, good.
I love him very much. I'm very proud of you.
Oh, thank you, Mom.
I'm very, very proud of you.
Grandma, I would never watch anything else. The only thing I watch is LeVar Burton.
And that is how I raised you, and that is how you will be forever.
Okay, are you feeling sleepy now?
Always.
Maybe go up to back to bed.
Oh, okay. Well, first I want to feed you.
Oh, cool. Okay.
I made you some food.
Oh.
I made you some food, your favorite.
Oh.
Do you like spaghetti and meatballs still?
Mm-hmm.
I made you extra balls. Meatballs.
Thank you, Grandma. Can I have it?
Yes. Am I looking at you too much?
No.
I'm just so proud of you.
No, Grandma, it's fine.
I'm so proud of you. I never thought you would be the man that you are.
Grandma, it's completely... Thank you so much.
It was really touch and go for a while there.
Mm-hmm.
But then you moved in with me and everything's good.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. You still feeling sleepy, Grandma?
I'm so sleepy. I'm so tired.
Oh, the bed. The bed's upstairs.
I don't know. I want to give you some of this drink that I made you.
Oh, what's the drink,
a
Grandma?
A milkshake, your favorite.
Oh, Grandma, thank you. Vanilla?
Vanilla, of course. I know you.
Thank you, Grandma.
You drink it now.
Okay.
I love you.
No, madam, this is the quietest blender on the market. You can make milkshakes and no one will ever know.
Are you sure? Because I'm very sleepy. And things big noises, loud noises really upset me.
Oh, well, then this is the blender for you. You're going to think it's not even plugged in.
Really? Okay, I will give you $600 for this blender if that is true. I know it's only $100.
Yeah, you don't have to give me the extra
but
money.
But I wanted to thank you and show my appreciation.
Don't thank me until you have this milkshake that I just made while we were talking. You didn't even hear it.
I didn't hear it. You're right. Sold.
Girl, that's a lovely story, but your eyes are bloodshot red. I really think
I'm just pushing along. I'm just going to stand here and hold myself up on the counter until I fall over.
Grandma, the counter's bending.
It's bending, yes. It's
how much pressure you're putting on it.
I shouldn't have made this counter out of this bending.
Well, you made it.
Now, a lot of counter materials, they're wasteful. You don't need a counter to be that solid. All you need the counter to do is hold up your microwave oven, your toaster oven, your toaster, and I don't know if you got one of those super silent blenders.
I do. I have those four things exactly.
Oh, here you go. Then this is the kind of counter material you need. We can have this made for you in the next 5 minutes.
I'm going to give you $1,000 for this counter.
It's literally $75.
Excuse me. Counter salesman?
Yeah.
Excuse me.
I'm in the middle of a sale here.
Excuse me. You sold me a counter last week.
Yeah, refresh my memory.
Okay. Well... it was a stormy day.
I remember that day. It was Wednesday.
That's right.
Wednesday of last week. Very stormy.
Okay, I remember the day. I thought it would be more specific to you and me.
Well, that's how I remember the day.
Okay.
I remember going outside.
We'll start there. We'll start macro and then zoom in.
Well, I was probably driving the Hyundai Elantra that I have.
All right. That wouldn't be something that I would really come into contact with.
They play California Dreamin' on the radio.
Okay, I feel like we're zooming out again.
That's a good song.
All right. Okay. I remember that there was a light that I usually make a yellow through, and then at that moment I said, you know what? I probably shouldn't take it.
Sure. Let me ask you this. Are you happy or sad with me?
Oh, thank you. I'm upset with you because of this counter. You promised me it was going to be a soft counter, and I body slammed my son on the counter, and he broke his back.
Oh, my. Well,
now, maybe, did you read the tag?
No, I did not read such tag.
There's a tag on the other side of all of our soft counters that says, too hard for human body
slams. Oh, my gosh.
Yeah.
I threw the tag right out once I installed the counter.
Oh, you shouldn't do that.
Well, it was a stormy day. It was wet.
The tag?
That's right.
But the rest of the counter was dry?
Oh, the rest of the counter was pure dry.
Excuse me, counter salesman?
Oh, what a day I'm having.
Excuse me, I have a problem with the counter that I got from you.
What seems to be the problem, sir?
All right, well, you remember me, don't you?
Yeah, refresh my memory.
Oh, God. It was, you know... it was my mom's birthday. I came in. You know, this is a counter I got for her. So, anyway.
And you're very happy with it?
No, I got a problem with it. That's the whole thing.
Never goes my way.
I bought one of your hard counters.
Yeah?
Yeah. Because, you know, I thought soft counter, that sounds like it will break. Hard counter, that's what I want.
Right.
My mom touched it. She died.
Oh. Oh, no.
She vaporized on her birthday. It was too hard.
Vaporized?
That's right. Oh, shocks ran down her body.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear mom. Happy birthday to you.
Oh, Mom, I love you so much. Look at this. I went to the counter salesman and I bought you this nice hard counter.
Oh, look at it. It's beautiful.
That's right, Mom. Give it a touch. Give it a brush.
Oh, may I touch and brush?
Of course.
Okay, let me just...
Wait, Mom, before you touch it, I just want to say that Brenda and I, you know, really worked on a present for you as well.
We put a lot of time and effort and energy into it. It's a picture collage.
That's right.
Of your children from when they were born all the way through now.
And Brenda went through and she cut up all your prize photos to make it.
I cut up all of them.
Okay, sounds like a lot of effort, but like not a lot of money spent. I spent a lot of money on this nice counter, Mom.
You did, Frankie, and they destroyed my family photographs.
That's right, guys. You hear that?
Well, yeah.
I think we made use of them. I think we made them better.
Thank you, Brenda. Absolutely.
Thank you, sweetheart.
I disagree. You've desecrated my most sacred memories.
Oh, really? Well, why don't you touch the counter then?
Oh, I Brenda. Will proudly Brenda. Touch the
Fine,
counter.
Touch the counter.
My favorite
Brenda,
what
is happening?
Just touch it.
Oh, how sharper than a serpent's tooth. Here we go. Getting ready to touch my new birthday counter provided by
it.
My favorite child, Frankie.
That's right.
Now, did she leave behind a little pile of dust, some shoes?
Yeah, it was a pile of dust and some shoes.
That was not a vaporization. That was spontaneous human combustion, not covered by our warranty.
Ah! Hey, I gotta say something, though. After listening to that story, it really sounds like your brother's wife killed Brenda. I mean, killed the mom.
I know! I also blame Brenda! God!
I don't know. I kind of feel like you're the one who brought the counter into the house. So maybe it was you. Maybe it's you. Maybe it's your
who
problem.
Who are you?
I was a grandma.
Hey, old lady, you stay out of this. Jeez.
Oh, dear.
Grandma again?
Grandma again? That's the sweetest thing you've ever said to me.
I know. I really think that maybe, you know, I can go back to watching TV.
Let's
like
have
I said.
A dance party. Let's dance. Okay. I haven't danced with a man
I'll do
years and years.
One dance, any song you want.
Oh, my favorite one.
Okay.
California Dreamin'.
I'm pretty sure if I turn on the radio, they'll be playing it.
Oh, sweetheart. Thank you so much.
Of course.
You're such a man. You're a real man with your dancing.
Grandma, can I just say
that was California Dreamin' by the Mamas and the Papas, and of course, an instrumental version for solo piano.
What are the chances?
This just in, we have breaking news. Ooh. If you bought a counter from Hardsoft Counters in the last 30 years, you are in grave danger of either spontaneous human combustion or vaporization. Check the weather so you can remember what day it was you bought the counter.
Oh, my God.
We now return you to the end of California Dreamin' by the Mamas and Papas.
Sweetheart, that's my counter. That's where I got my counter.
I don't know. What should we do?
I bought it on a Monday morning, 9 a.m.
I have a friend who just finished law school. I'm going to give him a call and see what he can do.
Ooh, is he handsome?
Yeah, sure.
Hello?
Hey, Evan.
Yeah.
Hey, my grandma just bought this counter, and they're going around saying that it's making people combust.
Oh, I heard that on the radio. I was looking for California Dreamin'. And I heard it.
Listen, I don't know if there's any way you could represent her in maybe like a class action lawsuit or something. I'm sorry, I've been watching a lot of Better Call Saul.
Wow. You know what, bro? I haven't heard from you in a couple weeks, and then you just call because you need a favor, you know?
I mean, I feel like, you know, not calling your friend in 2 weeks isn't that big of an offense.
I don't know. We used to, like, talk all night on the phone, bro, you know? I, like, miss that. I need that. I haven't been focusing in law school for a bit, you know? Because I miss
those
calls.
That's a lot of pressure to put on me, Evan.
I, like, really need that.
Evan, that's a lot of pressure to put on me.
Well, I'm an only child. I don't have a lot of people I can talk to, you know what I mean, bro? So, like, you know what? Okay, I'll come do this for you, Grandma, I guess. But you gotta call me more.
Okay, can you just come meet us at the house?
Oh, yeah, sure. Just text me the address.
Yeah.
Sweetheart, I appreciate you calling a friend over. I'm sure they're going to be here any second.
Of course.
In the meantime, I need to address the fact that you are watching Better Call Saul.
Oh, fuck. Did I say that out loud? I mean, it was LeVar Burton.
Yeah, that's what I thought it was supposed to have been.
No, Grim.
Better Call Saul is a scary show.
Yes.
It's too real.
Hey, old lady, you should really lock your door.
Evan, right. Please don't walk into this house with that sort of energy.
Don't call Hello, me old I'm doing lady. You a favor. Excuse me, I'm sorry.
Old lady?
I'm
what
so
kind
sorry.
Of greeting is that? I don't trust this person at all. Old lady.
Okay.
Sorry, this is Evan. He's an only child, therefore he has no sense of others.
I'm just a little high strung. I haven't been getting my nightly calls. It's okay.
Evan, this is my grandmother. She bought the counter. We're very worried that she's at risk of harm.
Yes, I'm very worried. This counter has been holding me up for at least
4 or 5 weeks, and I don't want to spontaneous combust or okay. vaporize. This is reasonable, right?
Sure. I'm just a little confused. Nothing has occurred? You guys are still okay at this moment in time?
Well, I guess at this moment in time, yes, we
so
are.
There's nothing really for me to fight here. It looks like we just got to return your counter and get you something from somewhere else.
Oh, yes, this makes sense to me. This is what we do. We just return it. Yes, well, nothing's happened yet.
Are you saying that we could fight and possibly make money if something were to happen?
Remember, students, in cases of wrongful death, the only way a plaintiff may collect money is if a death occurs. You may not sue for feared wrongful death.
How am I ever going to remember that for the test?
You won't. You have already failed. Remove yourself from my classroom.
Who's dragging me away?
Okay. You there, do you have any questions about the law?
No, Professor, I am all clear on the law. So you can't sue unless someone dies.
That's right, I'll call you later tonight.
Oh, cool. Yeah, looks like I can't do anything for you guys here.
Well, you could keep us company.
I mean, I'm not opposed to that.
I mean, you have a very you're a very charming person.
Oh my
goodness. I got beyond the old lady thing, and I like you again.
Wow. Hey, old lady, you flirting with me?
Maybe.
Oh my goodness.
Please, let's stop this immediately.
sweetheart.
I'm sorry. I was in thought because you said that if my grandma were to die, that there was possibly some money in it.
Okay, let's not talk about death so much.
Definitely. If she spontaneously combusted, we could get you millions of dollars, probably.
Okay,
now, let's say she died of another way.
Oh.
But we still wanted the money. We'd just have to connect it to the counter,
correct?
Oh,
we would just, I could find a way to connect it to the counter, I suppose. I mean, that's the best way to get money out of
all this. Now, what are some of these ways, if we were just...
I mean, here's the thing.
She could, you mean aside from exploding?
Yeah.
Well, I could just die, naturally, one day, and then you could have money then. Just, one day. Naturally, in my sleep.
I mean, Grandma, that's a great pitch, but I mean...
Also remember, compensation for death by natural causes is almost impossible to achieve.
Yeah, I don't think we can get anything for if she just dies on her own. Absolutely not.
Oh, man. Grandma, this is a tough choice.
How did we get here? I feel like we are putting my life at, okay, I don't want to die, but I'll put you through school. I have a lot of money.
Oh, I really want to go to Full Sail.
Okay, I have a lot of money under my mattress.
Really?
Yeah.
Enough for me to go to Full Sail?
Sure. Where's Full Sail?
It's in Orlando, Florida.
Oh, that Florida's awful. You should rethink that.
All right, let's do it.
Let's do it. I have a milkshake. What are we doing?
Oh.
Dance party.
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
You think?
Yeah.
I can't be an accomplice to this.
Okay, close your eyes.
Okay. La la la.
Remember, the surest way to avoid being an accomplice to murder, keeping your eyes closed. This is the Raiders of the Lost Ark defense.
Well, I can't stop looking at you because I'm just so proud of you.
Oh, my eyes are shut so tight.
Grandma.
I'll never stop looking at you.
Give me a hug, Grandma.
I'm never going to stop looking at you. No matter what happens to me, I will always be here looking at you.
Grandma, come on. I can't squeeze any tighter than this.
Oh, my God. Oh. Oh, jeez.
Okay, how much are we going to get?
Can I open my eyes?
Yes.
Oh, man. You killed your grandma?
Oh, Grandma.
Oh, thank God. Oh, jeez. Bro, that's what we were leading to?
What conversation did you think we were having?
I thought you were going to set me up with your old lady grandma.
No, this whole time I was asking if she were to die, how much would we get through compensation?
I thought it was hypothetical, bro.
I just want to say that was the best hug you've ever given me. Thank you so much, sweetheart.
Really?
Yes. I really feel your love now. You squeezed me so hard. It's undeniable. You love your grandmother.
Oh, I've never really had to process those kind of emotions. I mean, based on my actions here today, it's very clear that I'm a sociopath, and
that just like your grandfather.
What?
Yes, he was a sociopath, and I loved him to pieces.
Whoa, you guys really have a weird bond going on here.
Wait, Evan.
Yeah?
I want to apologize.
Oh?
I should have been there for you when you were going through law school.
Yeah, man.
Hey.
What?
Keep an eye on your phone tonight.
Oh? Oh. You gonna give me a call, bro?
I'm gonna give you a call.
Oh, man.
Or I might give you a text, too.
Oh.
Oh.
The door's open.
Hello. I'll get it.
Yes, hello. It's me, Dame Maggie Smith.
Hello, Maggie.
Oh, my gosh.
Oh, damn.
Someone in this room is scheduled to die.
Oh, damn. God.
I have been summoned here by forces I do not control, nor do I understand. But all I do know is a schedule is a schedule. Forgive me for saying schedule earlier.
I just can't believe you're actually here. This is amazing. I've loved you forever, like since Sister Act for sure. Maybe before that too.
Thank you. Well, anyway, one of you is to die in my arms.
Oh, Maggie, man. I don't mean to be rude, but...
Dame Maggie.
So sorry. Dame Maggie.
Call me Maggie.
Maggie, why are you the person telling us?
Since time immemorial, there has been a peer of the realm, the British Empire, assigned to usher people into the next world. And, well, it's my turn.
Oh, I feel honored. I really do. We've never had any royal adjacent people in this home before.
No. I mean, none. The guy... Well, we've let the guy who runs King Taco come in here a couple of times.
Yo, guys! I got your delivery from King Taco!
Hey, oh, man! Mr. King Taco!
Excuse you! Bow down!
Oh, sorry.
One taco for you.
Is it okay that I'm here, too? My son Frankie is the king of tacos.
That's me!
You're always welcome here.
It's my birthday, and we're going to celebrate at home later, but I thought I would join him on his taco round.
Yo, Mom, I got you the most baller gift!
Oh, don't tell me!
I won't tell you what it is.
Well, if you're here and you're going to take one of us, then I think it should be me. I mean, I've lived a long life, and fuck it.
What did you say?
I said, fuck it.
I'm afraid it's not up to me, dear. I don't get to decide.
No, it should be me. It should be me.
It is.
I put... It makes sense. I decided to put my television on the sidewall instead of over the fireplace like the obvious choice.
Why would you do such a thing?
Because I'm a sociopath, Grandma.
Oh. No.
I've never watched LeVar Burton once. I've only been watching Passion, Jerry Springer, and Better Call Saul.
Oh, Passion? No.
Yes, the NBC soap opera where there's vampires for some reason.
Oh, Passion. Oh, I'm into
passions.
That.
Passions. It's plural, dear.
Sorry, I didn't know.
It's more than just the one passion.
There's so many passions. They're just flowing.
Oh, man, bro, you gotta die.
I'll miss you.
Yes, I'm afraid your time has come, dear. Now, please, come into Dame Maggie Smith's arms.
How do I go?
How do you die?
Yes.
Well, I'm going to smother you to death.
Oh,
much like you tried to do to your dear grandmother.
It was still a very good hug.
Like Justin Timberlake said, what comes around, comes around.
Did he? Is that for real?
Yeah, it's a track on his best album.
What comes around, comes around.
Yeah, and it's like there's Indian instruments in the back, you know? Come on.
But it doesn't make any sense as an expression.
What comes around, comes around. It's like...
We've already established things come around. That doesn't need to be restated.
Look, okay, I didn't write his song. I mean, I pitched on it, but I didn't write it.
Come, dear, come into my arms.
I miss you, sweetheart.
Bury your head in my neck.
Can I make one last request?
I suppose.
I want you to go back, Maggie, and tell everyone that Hook was a better movie than people give it credit for.
Go back in time?
Yeah, bro.
Or back to England?
No, we'll never know what he wanted.
I should have let him answer.
Oh, no.
That one's on me. Well, I've got my work cut out for me. I have to figure out what he meant and then tell those people that Hook was a better movie than people gave it credit for. Although I think it gets more positive credit than it deserves.
I enjoy it.
Do you, old lady?
Truly. Yes, I eat paint all the time. It's delicious.
Oh.
Excuse me, ma'am. My manager told me that I can't sell you this paint in good faith because you come
starving.
Back with...
I haven't eaten since yesterday.
Yeah, that's why we can't sell it to you, ma'am. You don't even leave the store before you start eating it.
I know, but it's so good. It's just red. It's just red food.
It's... Man, please.
Look, try it. Have you tried it? You can't really speak until you try it.
We have snacks here at Home Depot. Like, you could have one of
those. Too many calories. I want the paint. I want the paint. I'm hungry. Hey, you want to come over and have some paint with me?
Attention, Home Depot shopper. We have just been informed that the song California Dreamin' no longer available for purchase at any platform. From now on, you will just have to find it on the radio.
Oh, man. Whoa. This is a sad day.
Well, goodbye to you and you.
Goodbye, Maggie. What am I supposed to do with his body?
Well, that's up to you.
Oh, I'll take it.
You'll take it.
I'll take it.
Thank you, Evan. You're so sweet.
Yeah.
I appreciate that.
Yeah, no problem.
What are you going to do with it?
I don't know yet, but it's going to be really special.
Oh, my.
It's going to be really special. Might keep him.
Gonna keep him?
I like might bury him.
Like a Weekend at Bernie's kind of thing?
Yeah, I might. I'll probably bury him. Which one's cooler?
I don't think either of those things are very cool.
Right?
But I appreciate you loving him as much as I did.
Oh, man. I'm so sad.
I'll just show myself out.
Okay, Maggie.
Sister Act 3? No?
I beg your pardon?
Are you gonna do it? Are you gonna do it?
Didn't I?
Sister Act 4?
How many?
I think there's a new one. I read that there's a new one coming out.
Look, just I don't have a whole lot of time. Toodaloo, everyone.
Goodbye, Maggie.
See you soon, Maggie. Evan.
That's right, buddy.
Evan, I just want to say congratulations on your wedding.
Thank you.
I'm really happy for you guys.
Thanks.
And I got to say, this kitchen counter, it's very unique.
Yeah.
It's almost more like a sculpture.
It is. That's, I had one of my best bros turned into a counter. I really couldn't see him go. I couldn't bear to part with him.
So you had, like, a sculptor make a counter that looked like your friend.
That's him. It's him. It's not a sculpture. It's his real body.
It's his body. It's real. It smells like him, too.
So happy we got married.
Me too. I told you I wasn't old. I have the spirit of a young lady.
Saw that paint you eat. Oh, I love you so much.
I love you so much. I love you so much.
Wait. Can I ask a question? I wanted to ask about that thing that y'all did at the wedding when you guys jumped over the broom. What was that all about?
Yeah, what is that?
Witchcraft?
Oh, my question was answered.
Oh, what? He just spontaneously combusted.
Oh, poor guy. Well.
Well, thanks for inviting me to your reception.
Oh, yeah.
Who are you again?
I'm a friend. I'm a friend of Evan's.
Yeah, it's my buddy from law school.
Okay, I was just wondering. I was just feeling a little jealous. I didn't know about this part of your life, having friends.
Hey, that's okay. Don't worry, baby. I don't have any friends no more. It's just you and me.
Excuse me.
What do you say, baby?
Excuse me.
Okay, yes.
Just come in.
Come on in. I always leave it unlocked.
Excuse me. You too. I had a law case done by you a couple of weeks ago. Do you remember me?
Refresh my memory.
Yeah, refresh.
It was hurricane out.
It was hurricane out?
That's right.
What?
There was a hurricane outside.
Okay.
Oh, I remember that.
But it wasn't outside in our immediate area. Well, it was somewhere in the continental United States.
Can you tell us the details of the case? Because we can't place the case.
Oh, right, wait, so the hurricane wasn't even local.
No.
It was just a day where a hurricane was happening somewhere.
I believe it was in August, which, according to my knowledge,
that's more helpful.
It's hurricane season.
Okay, this is August of last year?
In the Gulf Coast of America.
Okay.
I know that place, too.
All right. What was I wearing?
What was your case?
I probably wear one of three shirts. I have a shirt that has a Coca-Cola on it. I have a shirt that has a Sprite on it, and that's I have a shirt that has a Dr. Pepper on it.
Oh, okay.
Sorry, I'm late. Come here.
No, Maggie.
Wow.
Oh, sweet. I'm so glad we're going to have a baby.
Oh, my God. I'm so happy you can still have babies.
I knew I could. I had a feeling. Oh, and it wasn't until I met you that I was like, this feeling's real. Yeah. What comes around comes around.
Oh, that's a good JT quote, baby. Oh, yeah.
So, thanks for choosing me as your OBGYN. It's going to be smooth sailing. So, you are how old again?
92.
All right. So you know what you're doing. You've been around the block.
Yeah.
All right. You got two options here. You can either have the baby born like regular.
Okay.
Or you can have the baby born speedy.
Speedy sounds spicy.
Speedy, you get the baby faster. It's more time. Hugs, kisses, dress them up in costume, shit like that. Oh. But... probably a 70-30 risk that the mom doesn't make it through.
Oh.
I mean, well, let's take our chances. If you get to dress them up and parade them around in the speedy time, I mean, that would be worth it, right?
You think so?
Because, ma'am, let me correct me if I'm wrong. You don't care about kids.
I don't give a shit about kids.
You don't give a shit about them.
But our baby's going to be different. No more sociopaths in my family.
That's right, because you get some of my genes. Half your genes are my genes now.
Half my genes.
California law, 50-50.
Right? Oh my God, it's happening right now?
Hey, I told you I was good.
What? Oh my God. Oh. Look at this beautiful baby. Baby, you made it through.
I did it. I'm alive. Why? That cry is really annoying. Is he going to cry like that the whole time?
Oh, it's you again. Come here.
No. No, please.
Here we go. Just a little hug and then she's
gone. Maggie's... Oh. But at least I have you, baby. Yeah. At least I have you, huh? What should I call you? Let's see. I'm going to name you Old Lady.
Penny. You should name it Penny.
I'm going to name you Old Lady. What was that? Okay, what? Did you say I want to be named Penny? You can speak already? Damn, Speedy is too speedy.
What is this?
Oh, God. What?
Fuck it.
Oh, that's so cute.
And it all happened in a place called SpontaneaNation.
Carla Cackowski.
Hi.
It is Monday, November 19th. What do you want to tell people about? Where can people find you online, etc.?
I do a podcast called Craigslist Podcast, so you can find that online.
That's right, with our friend Carla Cackowski.
Paul has been on it a couple times.
It's true.
And will be again.
It's also true.
Also, I wrote and directed a web series that's going to be online by then called Badge of a Quitter, about a middle-aged woman who goes back to join a Girl Scout troop. So it's super fun.
I have followed it behind the scenes on Instagram.
Yeah.
And where can people find you online?
At Carla Cackowski.
There you go. It couldn't be simpler. Kimia Behpoornia.
Yes.
What you want to tell people about?
Let's see. You could come see me and Edgar at the UCB Theater. We're on a Herald team called Leroy. That would be great. I'm also on a mod team called The Summer Of, so catch that once a month. And, you know, I don't have a date for this, but there's a new NBC show called Abby's coming out mid-season sometime next year.
This is Kimia. This is our friend Natalie Morales. This is our friend Jessica Chaffin. Mm-hmm. They're all in one place.
That's right. It's very fun, so check that out. You can follow me on Instagram at ChildClown. or Twitter at ChildClown_, because some other freak wanted to be ChildClown too.
Edgar Momplaisir, all the same questions for you.
All right. November 28th, 29th, I will be in Chicago for Chicago Podfest. Come check out Culture Kings Live. Be very, very dope.
You're going to be there with Yo, Is This Racist, right?
That's
you guys
right.
are on the same night?
We are the same night. Fantastic. They are the show before us. We have promised that we will fight in the lobby in between. It's going to be a very, very fun time. Check out Sad Boy Edgar, my web series. You can find it on my website, edgarmobusier.com. Yeah, check out Leroy at UCB any Monday, Thursday, or Friday we're on. And yeah, listen to Culture Kings. Find me on Instagram at Awfulgram and on Twitter at Edgar Momplaisir.
There you go. Folks, let me tell you, bajillionaires live tomorrow night, the 20th of November. This is me and the cast of Bajillion Dollar Properties just doing some improv at UCB Franklin. This is our last show for the year. Hopefully we'll get to do more of these in the new year if UCB lets us. If not, we'll just take our business elsewhere. That's right, a direct threat. Don't forget to check out the PCAST Blast. This is an all-day podcasting affair at the Ace Theater at the Ace Hotel, downtown Los Angeles. Who's going to be on that? Teacher's Lounge, Off Book, the musical podcast, Throwing Shade, The Doughboys, The Andy Daly Podcast Pilot Project, and Comedy Bang Bang. These are all happening the same day, all live right in front of your face. That is Saturday, December 15th. And then Work Juice Improv in the new year. We are getting a permanent forever home at Dynasty Typewriter in Koreatown, Los Angeles. We're going to be doing the last Wednesday of every month. This is me and my improv friends from the Thrilling Adventure Hour just doing an improv show every month. So glad I get to see those knuckleheads on a regular basis again. Ladies and gentlemen, people, whoever you are, thank you for listening to the show. Thank you to Earwolf for hosting the podcast. Thank you to Engineer Sam for engineering us all the way to the end of the show, which this is. Goodbye forever. Until next week, this is Paul F. Tompkins saying, Semper in Presenti!